Hey everyone, Cas here, and SideQuest got another major update, so the developers asked me to make another video. And because I love the work that they do, I'm happy to support them with one. Plus, I want to keep my promise to keep you all up to date with SQ. So in this video, we'll talk about what's new in this update first, and then we'll go through the how to install and sideload guide again, but with the new design. If you already have SideQuest installed, then you do not need to go through the setup again. This is just for people who are new to SideQuest, but if you are not new to SideQuest, you might be interested in the what's new section of this video. Timestamps are available, like always. And if you want to stay informed about VR, then subscribe if you haven't yet. And now, join me beyond reality. So as part of this update, the developer of SideQuest gave the design another overhaul to make the user experience better. And it's mainly to improve discovery and community. For those new here, SideQuest is the unofficial source for Oculus Quest games and apps that are not in the official Oculus store. SideQuest is not for pirated games, okay, so don't do that. I also have to mention that when sideloading, please keep in mind that this is unapproved content, which could potentially harm or damage your device. If you want to be really safe, also check out the Oculus content guidelines to check if you are not violating anything, because violations can get your Oculus account blocked, and we don't want that. That said, I've been using SideQuest myself for years now, and I've been fine. So let's dive into it. As you open SideQuest, you will probably notice the changes immediately, like the browse and homepage is now merged into one, and there are more categories and filters. They also added a couple of new features, like a newsfeed, which you can find by clicking your avatar here and then dashboard. This is a place to get the latest news or updates about games that you've added to your wishlist or games you've installed on your Quest. In the future, the intention is to also find events like multiplayer sessions in the events tab right here. As a consumer, you can also add news posts yourself, but they do need to be approved by the game's developer. SideQuest also added an easier way to find games that are available on PC VR too, but this feature is currently in beta though. And then we have more filters now, like a dedicated one for web XR games. Check that out for sure if you haven't yet, because these are games you don't even need to download or install. You just need to load them in your Quest's internet browser, and then you can try them straight away. I think that covers most of the major stuff, but there are actually more quality of life improvements and features even, which you can read about in their Reddit post. I think the SideQuest team did an awesome job with this, but how about we dive into how to install and sideload now? Okay, so there's one thing to check before you install SideQuest, and that is if you have ever done anything with ADB or screen copy before, then you should make sure that you remove all old versions and remove any environment variables that you might have added for it. You can find ADB by typing where ADB in your command prompt, and then you should be able to find it. If you've never installed anything like you're seeing on my screen right now, then you're good to go. Step 1, download and install SideQuest on your PC. Now go to the first link, sideQuestvr.com/setup-how-to. I'll put this link in the description below, by the way, as well as all the links that I mentioned in this guide. And then you will get to this page, and hello to my old video over here. If you want, if you have Windows, you can download by clicking on this button right here, and it will start downloading immediately. You have to wait until it's done, and then you can click on it or find the file first in your downloads folder, and it will start the install process. And just click next, choose a folder where you want to install it, and then click install. Okay, so there's no need to start it yet, because we have to do something else first before it will work. Step 2, register as a developer on Oculus. To sideload on your Oculus Quest, you have to put your device in a developer mode, but before you can do that, Oculus requires you to register as a developer and also accept some of their terms. So to do that, we have to go to dashboard.oculus.com. And if you've never registered as a developer yet, then you should be put on this page straight away, at least if you have logged in right here. If you haven't, please log in and then reload this page. And then here you can put in your organization name, it can be anything you want. Click I understand after, then submit right here. And then you will get the agreement that you have to agree to. Just click on I've read and agree. Maybe read the terms first just to be sure and then click I agree. Once you've done that, your organization should appear right here at the left side. And now we can move to step 3, install the drivers. Now go to this developer.oculus.com link and you should be put on this page, Oculus ADB drivers. Get the 2.0 drivers, just click on this check mark, then download. Once downloaded, you have to find the file in your downloads folder. If you use Chrome, you can click on this arrow and then click on show in folder. I have all my downloads in my downloads folder, as you can see here, and I got the file right here. If you see this little zip around the folder, then you know that you need to extract it first, so please make sure to do that. Right click this file and then click on extract all. You should be able to use the default folder, which is in my downloads folder. Click extract here. Wait until it's finished and it should automatically open like here. Now go inside one more folder and then one more and find this file android_win_usb and right click it and then click install. Just click open and allow it if you get any messages. Once you get this message that the operation completed successfully, you're done. Step 4, enable developer mode and reboot. Now go get your Oculus Quest headset and a phone or tablet wherever you install the Oculus app on. And if you haven't installed it yet, you can find it for free in your phone's app store, but you probably already did. Now make sure that your Oculus Quest headset is turned on and booted. Now click on the Oculus app on your phone to start it and then go to the settings at the bottom right corner and click on your Oculus Quest headset. Wait until it connects, and once it's connected you can click on this arrow if it's not expanded yet and then click on more settings, then go to developer mode and make sure this toggle is on, like on my screen right now, and then go back one setting, go to unlock pattern and make sure that this is off. If you see this screen like mine over here, then you're good to go. Now one last step to do here, and this is just a just in case thingy, just reboot your Oculus Quest headset. I always just hold press this power off button until I hear this sound. Step 5, connect a USB cable. We're almost done. So what we need right now is a USB cable. I have a USB-C to USB-C cable for this. The other end is connected to my PC where I installed SideQuest, and this end is going into my Oculus Quest. Again, make sure that your Oculus Quest is turned on. As for the cable, you do need to find a compatible cable. Most USB 3.0 cables should work as long as it supports charging and data transfer simultaneously. And the cable that came in the box with the Oculus Quest should also work, by the way. Step 6, launch SideQuest and allow USB debugging. Now with your Oculus Quest connected to your PC, you can now start SideQuest. I have it on my desktop right here already, so I'm going to double click it. And then you have to go inside your headset because you're probably going to get a USB debugging permission window. Just put on your headset now. And if you get that pop-up, grab your controller and make sure you allow access. You can also select always allow from this computer too to make sure that you do not ever get this pop-up anymore. Now you might also not get this USB debugging permission window, then this could mean that you've already given it access before, maybe someone else did, and you could also get like a different pop-ups. Just click allow where needed, and if you get like an Oculus Link pop-up, then just click not now. Now in SideQuest, if you see a green icon at the top left here and an IP address and everything, then this means that your Oculus Quest has been connected successfully and you can start sideloading apps that you find on SideQuest here now. Just browse through it. In the next step, I will let you know how to do this. Step 7, sideloading games and apps and how to launch it. Now in SideQuest, you can scroll and browse a little bit. Find a nice little game or app that you like. For example, let me see, Hybrid Red Dash looks fun. Just click on it and you can look at like reviews and stuff. But if you want to install it immediately, just click on this button, Install to Headset. And it will start installing on your Oculus Quest immediately, if you have it connected still at least. And at the bottom here, you should be able to see when it's done. So just wait a little bit. If it takes really long, you can also see the process by clicking on this icon here. to see the running tasks. And while I clicked on it, it's done already. So it says the APK file has installed okay. You also saw it at the bottom here. And if that's done, this means it's installed on your SideQuest. You can unplug the cable and now you can find the app right in your Oculus Quest. So I'm going to put on the Oculus Quest. And now what we have to do is go to this icon for all the apps. And we go to this drop-down menu, which says all right now, but you have to go to unknown sources. It's at the bottom. And then the hardest part is probably finding which app it is. Okay, here is the app called Hyper Dash. This is the one I just installed. Just click on it and you'll be able to launch the app. Voila. And that's it, you are all ready to get started with SideQuest. Now you can just browse the app and find any app or game that you would like to try out. And all you need to do is press that install button as I explained in step 7. So I would say, have fun. In my previous video, I also explained how to record or live stream using SideQuest, but because all these steps is still the same, even with this design overhaul, I decided to not include it in this video. So if you want to know how to do that, then I recommend watching my previous video, which I will link in the description below. Now I hope this video was helpful, and I really do hope to see you back on this channel and see you in the next video. Now a special thanks goes to all our champions, our patrons and YouTube sponsors, and as always, VR on!